Life. Life is like a camera. You tend to focus on what's important. You capture the good times. And from time to time, you develop from the negatives. But if things don't work out, well then, you simply take another shot. Now let's recap my journey before this moment, before this new era of my life began.
Welcome to your life. There's no turning back. Even while we sleep, we will find you acting on your best behavior. Turn your back on Mother Nature. Everybody wants to rule the world. It's my own design. It's my own remorse. Help me to decide. Help me make the most of freedom and of pleasure. Nothing ever lasts forever. Everybody wants to rule. There's a room where the light won't find you. Holding hands while the walls come tumbling down. When they do, I'll be right behind you. So glad we've almost made it. So sad they had to fit it. Everybody wants to rule.
Hello, my name is Frederick Lopez, and besides making movies and telling stories like my role models, I just want to be the first Frederick Lopez.
Not much happened after that. I didn't stay in Austin as much as I would have liked. I didn't join the Austin Film Society because I had non-paid internships, and at that time I wanted a job that paid because I knew I wouldn't be able to stay there very long and afford a place. From Dusk Till Dawn didn't work out with the extras, and Disney was a great opportunity, but they had jobs where you had to pay and find your own place instead of it being provided. So if I was going to do that, it might as well be around locally. I missed out on a production assistant opportunity, and not much else was really available at the time. So I decided to take a bit of a break. I ended up moving out of the block around mid-July. It was really, really ran down, very different from when I left it. Austin has a lot of construction now lately, between Mopac and then by Dobie. Players Burgers is not there anymore, and it's very much changed. Pretty much, I finished from dreamer to director a couple of months late, but it really kind of gave me time to reflect. The first year off, I was looking, but really I was out of it after heroin. I was just mentally beat up. I was much better physically than I would be later, but I was just tired and burnt out. So I needed time to reboot. So here I am now. It's about a year or two later. So much has changed, but not changed at the same time. But I ended up going to San Juan. Went with my family. It was nice seeing South Texas again. I never thought I'd be a little bit obese again, moving back. But we went to San Juan to pray, and it was nice seeing the new H.M. King High School for a little bit. I caught up with my friend Fernando. It was nice that he was doing well. And as a trainer, he gave words of encouragement saying it's okay to get off track a little bit. It's just get him back on. I told him next time I see him again, I'll be skinnier. But here is some footage from being down in Corpus, and I had an idea of doing the hit too.
Don't worry about talking, it's gonna be set to music. If I can stop it from shaking. Oh my god, that's fucking awesome. Got that orange car moving in front of us. It really makes it look like you're in the glitz of like Miami or something, but it's Corpus Christi. All we need is like an orange Ferrari to come up.
Wow. Look at all those waves crashing in.
After that trip, my oldest nephew, Zachary, was soon leaving off to college, to Southwestern University in Georgetown, Texas. It was so strange because I vividly remember my first time going to college, away from home, like it was yesterday. So here is him leaving for the first time. Right now, my nephew is leaving to college for the first time, so I'm about to view that, him leaving. So let's see.
Bye-bye. Enjoy. Bye-bye.
That, my friends, was the circle of life. Now I'm gonna deal with my messy room and figure out what to do with my life. But not after I have a Dr. Pepper tin. During this, he left. Not much went on, so I decided to continue building myself together. I tried to start working out. However, I was having a hard time. And then I got to meet Cristela Alonso in San Antonio, Texas. Got to take a picture with her. I saw her and a great other few comedians in San Antonio, Texas. So that was nice. But during this, I had an idea to write Hit 2, but I couldn't really get any further in it. I had a writer's block. I still needed my creative flair. So I decided to approach things differently and do what Cinema Lab did and taught me, and it's just create stuff on the fly. So at the start, when we saw Christelle, I started filming at the hotel, and then just different area all around my phone, and some of the clips later on ended up becoming misread. But here's a picture of Christelle. And then after that, I pretty much took it easy, worked on misread, and then my dad had an honorary award for being principal at University High. So at their homecoming game, he was awarded, and here's some footage of that, as well as me finding my sister in the bleachers.
In our newly created Lifetime Athletic Honor. We're gonna drop a fourth down.
Yeah, we're gonna come down right in half. We're gonna go up for a little bit.
Everyone knows you get the best chicken. The best tender, the best feed.
What?
We're gonna go right through here. We're gonna go up for the elevator.
Okay. Let's go to the press box. Not too bad.
There's no way.
Just keep going like you don't really like. Keep going, make a left.
You can come down at 5-2.
Darn, it's cooler where we were at, Johnny.
Yeah, I know it.
We brought Trojan some luck down there.
How are you?
So right now, I'm in the press box, and I see my sister sitting with me. It was a great night for my father. It's such an honorary reward. One day I wouldn't mind being awarded like that, and I'll be lucky if I'm half the man he is. So it's pretty stagnant. However, I started to get misread done, and then an unfortunate circumstance happened. I had a sty in my eye. I know that rhymes, it's so messed up, but it's true. First time since I was 6 years old. I was worried that I was going blind, or I had a mini stroke, but no, it was a sty. And that worried me. I thought I was going blind, and I thought first I would never see my friends again, but never see any film. And that really bothered me. And that's what jump-started my creative flair to use the sequences and put together for Misread. So here's just raw footage of the film Misread.
And I was looking forward to tomorrow. But I guess you could say a person like me looking forward to anything is somewhat of a paradox. Depends on what, you ask. If you like something of a paradox, you're asking if I found something evil, something hidden. depends on your definition. But what I found was not hidden, but it was evil. More evil than you could possibly imagine. And it was in plain sight the minute I discovered it.
Well, supposedly it's an escape key. Clean any record, you can be anybody, anywhere in the whole world. Millionaire, artist, or don't even exist. I mean, it's just fucking incredible.
What do you want? I want what's best for you. Bullshit. You don't want what's best for me. Is that so? You're really gonna pull that shit after everything? After all, I am you. What is it that you want? Huh? You're not answering, are you? Why the hell should you? Why? Bastard. Why answer? Oh, sitting down there, staring. You bastard. I want to help you. Help you get away from your sad, pathetic life. That's what I want to do. You see, I'm not such a bad guy once you get to know me, Jake. I'm just the better part of you that's beckoning to come out. And what's up with his hair? There, it's a little bit better, a little bit you, a little more sloppy. Oh, you just need to let loose.
See, that was an almost time.
Okay. It must have did.
I must have accidentally.
You! Huh? You?
Oh. I know, pretty strange, right? But in the story, I was going against my other personality. But trust me, my parents were wondering what the hell I was doing at 2 a.m. in the morning. But you know, that's the thing about being a filmmaker. No matter what time it is, you come up with an idea, and you just film something. And you can see the film on Vimeo and YouTube. I saw the politics, and I wanted something not only to reflect the politics that are going on in our country and what's happening, but I wanted something with technology to do something different, and I was going to get an actor, but I decided to act myself, and I never played a villain. And I decided to do it with a guy who opens a subliminal message and is afraid that the government's after him, when in fact it's his split personality disorder, his dissociative identity disorder that is actually bringing him down. That got my creative flair back. I enjoyed filmmaking again. It was a bit vulgar and really dark, more dark than I thought it was going to be. But I just needed to get that part of myself out. I was a fan of the opera for Halloween. Soon after that, what do you know, it was future day. There was no flying cars, and much was very different in my life. However, I still celebrated future day by watching the Back to the Future films. I also recorded the Blood Moon. The next time I would see one, I will be in my 40s. It's kind of crazy when you think about it that way. It puts perspective to how short life is. Before you knew it, Star Wars Force Awakens came out, Christmas, and then January. And that's when I knew I had to get my shit together. So I got my resume, doctored it up, put some of the freelance work I got, put it in there, and wanted to apply for an editing job at KCAN. The editing jobs are closed, so I tried for part-time production assistant. So right now, it's January 16th, 2016. I just started Sicario and ordered an awesome place called Marco's Pizza in Waco. There's a pizza, got a sub for later, and a drink in the bag. And it's great! As a matter of fact, for those in Austin, the Austinites, it tastes exactly like Austin pizza, which is really great, especially where I'm at right now. Right now, I'm going to enjoy one of the best-reviewed films of 2015, Sicario. I am kind of behind on it, but we'll see how it is. And it's a little bit shaky because it's on a webcam. Okay, so right now, it's January 31st. I found a part-time editor job at KCN here in Waco, but it just went off, so I didn't get to it in time. And there's production assistant. It's just that the part-time editor, it was preferred to have experience, but you didn't need to have experience. But that sucks, I didn't get to that in time. It really has been spread thin. And there's been some stuff with production assistants, but you have to have 3 to 5 years of experience, which in my field, that wasn't there. And then there's some experience, and it's good to get your foot in the door. The thing is, it's just non-paid. So, like, you're basically working for free, which is not bad. It's just that when you need to, like, pay for an apartment and everything else and food, that kind of sucks. So, my life is not how I imagined it would be right now. A year from now, 2 years, I don't know. But I am in a limbo state, going nowhere. And I don't have enough money to go to Los Angeles where the industry is, so I'm pretty much fucked. I need to find something, just anything, but if not, I may have to go back to school for something else. So after all my hard work, I didn't really want to. But that's the life of a postgraduate.
All these people saying you need more experience, which is great. Have ingenuity. It's nice for them to say that when they got an entry-level job without having to have 3 to 5 years of experience getting into the workforce. I'll update you after.
After that, I turned 25 years old. I don't know what to do with my life. I feel like I'm kind of a failure. I'm not where I thought I would be in life, but you know what? I'm in my mid-20s and it's freaking me out. Half my 20s are gone already. It's like Billy Crystal's speech at the beginning of City Slickers. Then I look back at most famous people, J.K. Rowling, Oprah Winfrey, and a lot of them were not where they were at my age. It didn't take until their 30s where they got successful, so it's just trying again. So I tried again. I polished my resume, and then I sent an application for the news department to be a part-time production assistant. All that was left was waiting for a phone call or an email. Meanwhile, here's footage of my birthday.
I mean, how can you have a sport with people with, like, a stick in between their legs running around in the field?
Prostitutes.
Prostitutes?
I hate my life on it.
What can I say? Snitches and bitches.
What do you know? Lent came by, went to St. Louis. Then I did some early voting. I decided not to vote for Trump. He's a bigotry asshole. Excuse my vulgarity, but it's true, and I voted for Hillary Clinton. I didn't get the production assistant, and it kind of bothered me. So I continued to look. Meanwhile, I started to feel bad physically. And then I got a toenail infection. I stubbed my toe. I started to feel bad. But meanwhile, during the Christmas winter time, I had a water leak. Our roof was leaking and my room had a water leak and had to get everything out. So I was not living in my room. It had to be completely redone. But meanwhile, I got a new room out of it and a new video shelf. But soon after this, I was setting up my room and I accidentally stubbed my toe on a PlayStation 3. It was okay, it was just cut a little and kind of wedged, so I just trimmed it a little so it wouldn't get caught on my sock. However, this became a problem 2 weeks later when it became infected because a nail grew into the skin. Quite scary, I thought I would never walk again and I was just worried that I would, like, lose my leg. My toe thankfully healed, but here's just the progress of what it was like. Quite scary.
Okay guys, I just got back. That photo you saw, I stubbed my toe a couple of weeks back. Saw it on my computer now, but I stubbed it while redoing my room on the PS3. It cracked a bit, so I got the top half, but since it did the top half, it was short and grew into the skin, so I have an affected toenail that's also ingrown. So, I have to take some antibiotics and some soak, and then if not, we're going to have to pull it out, which is a first for me. Right now I'm not doing so hot, and if I heal and survive this, then I want to come back 100% and forget being the old Fred again with fitness and everything. I'm going to be the new Fred, arriving at the end of 2016, get my life back in shape.
Okay, so right now it's April 4th, I made me some oven pizza, but my toenail didn't quite heal. I was just digging a little bit of dirt, and on the base of the nail started bleeding. It freaked me out. But it's just the nail growing to the skin now. So tomorrow, we'll see if I have to or not with surgery, but we're going to get part of the toenail removed for the ingrown toenail caused by the stub and the infection. I'm not really looking forward to that. I want to close my eyes, but it's the first time I've gone through that, and I guess 25 is a better time than any, and yeah, I'm not really looking forward to that, so we'll see, and hopefully I survive, hopefully I can walk, hopefully it's just a toenail, we'll have to see. But, yeah, afterwards, we're getting Star Wars Force Awakens, and then hopefully I can have a speedy recovery. I really want to get to driving and filming something and walking around, so we'll see. Yeah. Meanwhile, during this time, Batman Superman came out. I didn't think that movie was as bad as what everyone said. And it's sure better than Batman and Robin. But meanwhile, Ben Affleck got me in my Batman mood again. And thanks to Mascared, here's me talking.
Do you bleed? You will.
Then Easter came along. It's sad, out of all the grandkids, my nephews and niece, at 25 years old, I still color eggs with my mother. But what can I say? I'm a child trapped in a man's body.
My hands, it's not coming out of my hands either, that gel. Look at that. I'm going to go to church. I have to get alcohol. I got to do my nose in a minute. I'm going to sit down.
Well, let's hope it doesn't wear off, otherwise it'd be in the holy water.
After the heal up and stuff, I was worried. My mom had a procedure, and it was quite basic, but you never know what happens in the hospital. And I just started feeling kind of upset about it. I thought of memories back when my dad was diagnosed with colon cancer and had to remove her tumor out. So I was kind of on edge that week until she got out, thankfully. Now she's recovering from the procedure, but it really had me worried. And not only did it make me think of the time with my mother, with my parents, but it reminded me of my own mortality and how precious life is and how little time we have to do what we need to do and what we want to get done.
Right now, it's about 6:34, and I'm waiting for my sister, my parents, hopefully, already left to the hospital. She's gonna go through the procedure, we're gonna see how she's doing. I'm gonna wear a cap, my hair can't stay down. And my toe, I think I took the bandage off too early because it's feeling kind of weird with the shoe and everything, so I'm gonna do a soak when I get back. Give me some bottled water and stuff, and we'll see, hopefully all is well. It's early for me right now. It's still dark. Sun's not out yet. Right now it's almost 6:40, waiting for my sister, and got my cap on, my hair couldn't stay up. Listening to The Hills by The Weeknd from Beauty Behind Madness album. Fantastic song, be good for a slow motion sequence in a film about like the destruction, self-destruction through fame. Having everything but yet losing everything. I had an idea like that in 2004. Basic trope in films, but I wouldn't mind doing one. Video shelf's there. Has Star Wars, so. Kinda have a headache still, but we'll see. So, right now, my mom is in the waiting room. My dad's doing a shot before his meal, but we got this for breakfast. Providence. Not bad. We'll have to see how it goes. But right now, we're waiting. We're gonna eat and then go back up and hopefully everything goes okay, so we'll see. We'll see how it goes.
I drove it a couple days this week. Maybe I'll check it out of town one day.
I then thought of a way to just experiment again. I need to film something. So I end up trying to write a script. And then I thought of a still frame animated idea. I wanted to do a vampire still frame animated film like Timeless and West Coast Contrition. I was like going on and off about it. So I decided to draw for fun. And then a friend of mine, Savannah, really liked the pictures on Instagram. And I was like, you know what? Maybe I should make it. I might try to have it motion, but either way, it's going to have voices this time around, and it's going to be like a motion comic book. So I'm looking to get that done, and then I saw that the Austin Film Festival has some screenplay openings. I think I may run and write a screenplay. I wasn't that great in screenwriting, but I kind of decided to leave the trepidation I had at UT and the negative criticism from other peers and just go for it, because you never know what happens when you jump off. You take that leap of faith. Then, I ended up doing a fan video and artwork for Highlander. I don't know about the artwork, but the review thankfully came in, which I'm very happy about. And they're going to use it on their fan hosting, so I'm very honored. I love the El Rey Network and wouldn't mind working for him or meeting Robert Rodriguez in the future. But it's just great, so it should be out early May. And I'm excited. I'm excited to see where the fan hosting's going to be. Highlander is one of my favorite films and an inspiration to me as a filmmaker. So besides writing a screenplay and doing a still animated film, I want to make a film, different film, drama, whatever, for a film festival. I feel like I'm ready for it. I could do a short film, but I feel like I can do a film. Do something, at least get some recognition where I can use this free time and doesn't look like a waste. It's crazy, these 2 years, even the last year, it feels like 3 months to me since graduation. The first year, I had to get through stuff mentally. This year, it's just physically health-wise. So after everything healed up, I decided to exercise again, P90X.
Man, 30 minutes later, that was the first day of P90X. The Daredevil album. Whew. I'm more out of shape than I thought I was. But we'll see. Hopefully I get ready for when I film Hit 2 or House of Vengeance. So we'll see.
And it's great. So far, since graduation, I've lost 30 pounds. I'm looking to lose almost 100, if not maybe 50 to 60 this time around. Not get too skinny, but not be too overweight. I just want to be fit and healthy more than anything. It's not about being fat or skinny. It's just healthy. So I look forward to that. You may ask, wow, not much happened. I know. I'm trying to process that, but you know what? A beautiful miracle happened. I became an uncle again. My brother and sister-in-law gave birth to their daughter, Athena, named after the Greek goddess. She's such a cute baby, and I can't wait to see her next month. The reason why I want to make Frederick Lopez Filmmaker is to show what it's like. Other people have better stories. They're better off than I am. They're much more intelligent than I am. But you know what? This is my story, and I want to share it. It shocks me, because the millennials, I was born in 1991, but people, Generation Y millennials, make up 40% of the unemployed, and that gap's only going to get more larger as the baby boomers get out. And that bothers me. It bothers me that with all the education and stuff, we have to pay for tuition, debt, federal loans, and it upsets me. We should have free education. Knowledge should be free in the land of opportunity, and I feel like the American dream is in a way dying because of greed. And then independent filmmakers and editors make up 11.9% of the unemployed. So the start of this is not just figuring out what to do with my life, but to explore other people's lives, whether they're filmmakers or not, to show the differences and similarities between all of us. I want to see what other people in my generation are up to. I feel like one person can make a difference. It's like JFK's words, ask not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country. And if I try, maybe I can get others to try. Maybe I can see how others do. And we all together can figure out what to do with our lives. We're all on a journey. Many of us have different stories. So that's chapter one. I'm at a crossroads here. It may seem like nothing much compared to your lives out there, but this is how it's been. Is it what I imagined it to be? No, not at all. But you know what? Hello, everyone out there. I'm assuming you made it this far. You saw how I've been lately. I need to get my stuff together. But, like I said earlier, life is like a camera. Focus on the moments. You can develop from the negatives. Use your experiences. And if you don't get it right the first time, well then, you can just take another shot. And that's what I plan on doing. I plan on taking another shot and getting it all back. But most of all, I want to continue learning from my filmmaking peers, my role models, and I want to be the first Frederick Lopez.